The liver is our next accessory organ. The liver secretes bile, and I'll give you more detail on bile in just a moment. The liver does a lot of nutrient processing. So it can take glucose and it can turn it into glycogen. Do you recall the name of the process that converts glucose into glycogen? Would it be gluconeogenesis, glycogenesis, or glycogenolysis? So if you're taking glucose and you're forming glycogen, that's called glycogenesis. So, would you be doing this during a period where you had an excess glucose or not enough glucose? Just a question for you to think about. Now, the liver will also take amino acids and convert them over to fatty acids. The liver will synthesize triglycerides and cholesterol. And remember, the synthesis of triglycerides is called lipogenesis. And the liver will also do lipoprotein synthesis. The post-absorptive state is a state where you've not eaten or you're in a fasting state. And the absorptive state means you've had a meal and it lasts for 3 to 4 hours after your meal. So you want to think about which of these processes might be occurring in these different states. The liver also removes old red blood cells, as does the spleen. We'll talk about the spleen's role later. This removal of red blood cells is caused by a type of white blood cell called a macrophage. So when we remove old red blood cells, that means that we're going to metabolize hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a polypeptide, and it carries oxygen. These macrophages break down hemoglobin. This generates bilirubin, and bilirubin gets eliminated as bile from our body. The other thing that the liver does is it synthesizes plasma proteins. So for example, it's going to synthesize albumin. Albumin, which you've heard of by now, is a protein that carries hormones throughout the plasma. The liver also synthesizes clotting proteins. These are proteins that you'll need in order for your blood to clot. The liver will also synthesize a hormone called thrombopoietin, and that hormone is important in clotting. The liver also produces angiotensinogen. Lastly, the liver will secrete and modify hormones. And I'll give you just one example here that we're going to use later. These are the somatomedins, and the somatomedins are insulin-like growth factors. We'll discuss those later. So let's connect the liver to the gallbladder and the associated ducts and how this fits in with the major organs of the gastrointestinal system. So we know that the liver synthesizes bile. So we have the bile and the gallbladder that stores the bile. So in terms of how this fits in with the duodenum and how these and how the bile gets down to the duodenum, we have what's called the common bile duct. That's connected to the gallbladder. And then we have the ampulla of Vater and the sphincter of Oddi. And then there's the duodenum. So again, this is how this will work. In the presence of food, the gallbladder will contract. So you squeeze on the gallbladder, the bile passes through the cystic duct, through the common bile duct, through the ampulla of Vater, and remember that's the common passageway for both pancreatic juice and bile, through the open sphincter of Oddi, and then into the duodenum. Remember, the sphincter of Oddi is only relaxed in the presence of food.